The next topic is radius of gyration. So what is this radius of gyration? This is a body and this is the axis of rotation. Let us have taken so many particles inside this body. So these are the different particles of this system. And already we found the moment of inertia of this ith particle. So the distance of ri with mass mi and moving with a velocity, angular velocity omega. So how to find the total moment of inertia of this body? The total moment of inertia of this body is given by moment of inertia of the first particle plus moment of inertia of the second particle plus moment of inertia of the third particle, so on, moment of inertia of ith particle, and so on, moment of inertia of the nth particle. So from this I am going to write this as m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus mi ri square plus mn rn square. Now from this what I am going to write, we know that this is the sum of the moment of inertias of the individual particles. So simply I am going to write mi ri square with I starts with 1 and ends with n. So this is the moment of inertia of this body. Instead of this, if you know that, we know that m1 plus m2 plus m3 and so on, mi and so on, mn is equal to total mass of the body, which is given by capital M. Now, in this case, this same expression can also be written as total moment of inertia of this body is total mass into this, I can be written as total mass of the body into total radius of this one about that axis, that is the point at which the total mass is concentrated. So this is irregular body. Let us say this is the point where the total mass is concentrated and this distance is called K. So we call it as K, which is known as the radius of gyration. So we can write the total moment of inertia of this entire body, I total, is equal to total mass of this body, that is m, into square of the distance between the axis of rotation and the center of mass of the body. So this is k. So now how to define this k? I is equal to mk square. So we can write k square is equal to I by m, or k is equal to root over I by m. So this is the moment of inertia of this body I, and this is the total mass of this body, and this is called radius of gyration. So how to define radius of gyration? It is the square root of the ratio between moment of inertia and mass of the body. So radius of gyration is defined as, it is defined as the square root of ratio between moment of inertia and mass. Moment of inertia and mass of the body. Now, in this case, how to find the SI unit and dimension formula for radius of gyration? Very simple. For this one, while writing this, we have to see that this moment of inertia is measured in kg into meter square by mass is measured in kg under root. This kg, kg get cancelled. Root over meter square is nothing but meter. That means the radius of gyration is nothing but a radius only. That's why it can be measured in meters. And if you know this, this is in 1 meters, the dimension formula will be L power 1. As I said earlier, in some books it is given as m power 0, l power 1, t power 0 also. So both are similar dimensional formulas only. Now, after finding, after learning how to determine the moment of inertia of a particle, now I am going to find out moment of inertia of different bodies, that is different geometrical figures. Here I have taken one ring having total mass m, and the radius of this ring is r. Here this ring has a large number of small particles in it, so each and every particle in this one is traveling with some linear velocity v, which is given by r omega, if omega is the angular velocity of this ring. Let us say it is rotating about this axis, so which is into the board. So about this axis this ring is rotating like this. If the ring is rotating, what is the kinetic energy of the total ring here? The kinetic energy of the ring is given by half into total mass into total velocity. But what is the velocity of each particle? This is r into omega. So what is the total velocity here? This will become half into m into r omega whole square. This is half into m into r square omega square. So this is the total kinetic energy of this particle. If you compare this k is equal to half m r square omega square with the kinetic energy of a body in rotational motion, already we derived this as half I omega square. Compare this, this half half get cancelled, omega square omega get cancelled. So the moment of inertia of the ring about that axis which is passing through the center of mass, why? Because this axis is passing through the center of mass of this body and perpendicular to the plane of rotation. So this will be the moment of inertia of the ring, which is given by m r square. So this is very very important derivation. Actually the derivation is not there in our PU syllabus. We are going to learn these derivations in second year physics after getting some grip over the integration only. Why? Because to derive this equation we need to use integration. Now similarly, let me take one more example. Now I have taken a thin rod. Thin rod means mass is negligible here. Thin rod, that means massless rod, or mass is negligible. If I keep two bodies here, this is mass m, this is mass m. So let me take this mass m, this mass m. If I keep two masses here, let me take one axis which is passing through the center of mass of the system, and if I am rotating this rod in a particular direction like this, let the length of this rod is l. So I am going to denote this length of the rod from here to here, this is l. So this will become L by 2, and this is also L by 2. We know that here the mass of the rod is negligible, so don't consider the mass of this rod. You consider only mass of this small particle here. So now what is the moment of inertia of this mass which is rotating in a circle of radius L by 2? So for this let me take the first particle here, the second particle here. So what is I1? I1 is mass of the particle into and the square of the distance between axis of rotation and this particle, that is L by 2 whole square. So this is the general formula, mass into square of the distance. So this will become M L square by 4. Similarly, what is the moment of inertia of this one? From here to here distance is L by 2, mass M. So I2 can be written as M into L by 2 whole square. Once again, this is M L square by 4. Don't think that it is rotating in this direction, this is rotating in another direction. So some students are taking this as a negative I, because moment of inertia is not a vector. So just add them. So the total moment of inertia of the system of two particles which are rotating with along an axis which is passing through the center of mass and perpendicular to the length of this rod is given by I is equal, just add these I1 plus I2, which is going by ml square by 4 plus ml square by 4. So this is ml square by 4 plus ml square by 4. That is 2 ml square by 4 or ml square by 2. So these are the two simple methods of finding moment of inertia of a ring, as well as two mass particles of masses m each rotating on the edges of a thin rod. Here the moment of inertia of some regular shaped bodies about their some specific axis. First, I am going to take a body, circular ring. of radius r, mass is always m only. So about which axis? So this axis passing through center of mass of this ring, circular ring, and the perpendicular to the plane of the ring. So what is the diagram for this one? So I am going to draw one diagram. So this is the ring, a thin ring. Remember, this is not a thick ring, this is a thin circular ring. Thin circular ring, this is the axis. So let me draw the axis here. So this axis is passing through the center of mass. Center of mass of this ring is this one. So let me take this point as CM, and here the axis is passing through the center of mass and perpendicular to the plane of the ring. So what is this plane of the ring? Now if you take this box here, you just observe only the circumference of this one, only the circumference. Just imagine only the ring here. Now the plane, this is the plane. Why? Because if you keep it like this, this is x axis and this is y axis. So this ring is in xy plane, but the axis is perpendicular to this plane. Don't consider the entire ring here, only the circumference. Don't consider the entire plate here, only the circumference. So if you consider only the circumference, that is the ring, and the axis is passing through the center of mass and perpendicular to the plane of the ring. Now how to draw that axis here? I have to draw a line like this, but which is not possible for me. That's why I am going to draw one axis here like this. So this is the axis which is passing the center of mass and perpendicular to the plane. The moment of inertia is given by the final expression, I is equal, now the total mass of this ring is m and the radius of this one is r. This is given by m r square. Next, if you take the same thin circular ring of radius capital R only, now I am going to change the axis. The axis is not perpendicular to the plane of the ring, but here also it is passing through center of mass and about any diameter. Now the axis is passing through any one of the diameter here. So I am going to draw the same ring here. This is the ring and this is the center of mass. Now the axis is not perpendicular to this one, it is parallel to the plane like this, and about any diameter. You can draw here, 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 anywhere. Now this is a parallel to plane of ring. So in this case, the moment of inertia I is given by m r square by 2. Dear students, the proof or the derivation for this moment of inertia for these cases is not there in first PUC. Once again, I am telling you, you have to by heart these formulas. And please remember, don't confuse between that formula and this formula. This is a axis which is a perpendicular here. So instead, if you don't want to draw this one like this, you can draw like this also here. This is the axis into the board. So this is passing through the center of mass and the perpendicular here. I am not showing that one. Actually, I have to draw like this only. But here it is parallel. This is perpendicular to this one. Now the third case is circular disc of radius r. Now here the axis is passing through center of mass and perpendicular to the plane of the disc. Perpendicular to the plane of the disc. Here, how to draw this diagram? Here, I am going to take a disk here, that is a plate here. But how to find the, show the difference between the ring and the plate? Here what I am going to write? I am going to draw some lines here. So this is a plate here. So that is the difference between the ring and the plate. So this is the plate. And how to draw the axis here? This axis is passing through center of mass and perpendicular to this plane. This is the plane in which the disk is placed. So perpendicular to the plane is this one. So this is the axis which is perpendicular to the plane. And the mass of this one, it is not given m only. This is also m. This is radius r. And here radius, this one is r. The moment of inertia of a circular disk of radius r such that the axis is passing through the center of mass and perpendicular to the plane of the disk is given by I is equal, this is given by m r square by 2 once again. Remember, moment of inertia of a ring about an axis which is passing through the center of mass and parallel to the plane and about any diameter is m r square by 2. But here perpendicular to the plane of the disk is also m r square by 2. Now the fourth one, same circular disk only of radius r, same circular disk, but now the axis is passing through center of mass and about any diameter. Any diameter, you can take diameter in any direction. So now this is the disk here, and the disk means you just show like this. These are the lines which are showing the difference between the disk and the ring. Now what is the direction of the axis in this case? The direction of the axis in this case is any diameter. It may be along this path or this path, this path or this direction. So let me take this diameter like this, but it has to pass through the center of mass. This should not go like this, then it will become a diameter, remember. So this axis should be along a diameter only. Now in this case, what is the moment of inertia? This is half of this value. You see, this is half of this value and this is half of this value. So the answer is m r square by 4. Fifth one, body is hollow cylinder, the axis of symmetry or axis of cylinder. This axis passing to the axis of this hollow cylinder. Now how to draw the figure? Remember, how to get a hollow cylinder? If you keep a ring over another ring and one more ring, if you arrange ring over the ring, you will get a cylinder. So what I am going to draw, this is a ring, one more ring beside this one, one more ring beside this one, one more ring beside this one. If you continue like this, ring over the ring beside this one without any gap between them, and then you will get these cylinders. So this is a hollow cylinder. This is the diagram. But how the axis is passing here? The axis is axis of the cylinder only. So I am going to draw the axis here. So this is the axis of the cylinder. This is the axis which is passing through this one. This is the axis. Let us say the cylinder is rotating about this one. Now when the cylinder is rotating like this, then what is the moment of this one? Moment of inertia of the hollow cylinder. Just now we found that a hollow cylinder is a combination of so many rings. If the mass of each ring is m, radius of this one is r, moment of inertia of the first ring is I1 is equal to m r square. second ring I2 is equal to mR square. Similarly, the last ring, this one, for this one, In is equal to mR square. We know that moment of inertia is a scalar quantity. If you add all these, that is I1 plus I2 plus I3 and so on, In, you are going to get mR square plus mR square and so on, mR square. But what is common here? M is common, R is common. So you can take 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you take R square common, you will get M plus M plus M plus and so on. So what is the sum of all these masses? It is nothing but total mass of this ring only. So now what we can write? This is I is equal to mR square. The moment of inertia of the hollow cylinder is mR square, which is similar to the moment of inertia of a circular ring of mass m and radius r. So this is how you can find the moment of inertia of a hollow cylinder. So please remember this concept. Now, in the next case, sixth one, let me take hollow cylinder. Instead of hollow, we are going to take a solid cylinder. And the axis is the axis of the cylinder only. The axis of cylinder, that means the axis of rotation is passing through the axis of cylinder. But how to get a solid cylinder? Once again, the concept is very simple. If you keep one circular disc over another circular disc and one more over it, if you arrange all these circulars one over the other, and finally you will get one solid cylinder. In messes or these in hotels, they arrange these plates one over the other, and if you watch it from a large distance, you can see that as a steel cylinder. But if you go nearer to that, you can find some layers of these plates there. So this, how to get this solid cylinder? So this is a circular disc like this. Now if you arrange so many circular disc like this, so this is the solid cylinder in this case. To get the hollow cylinder, I need to arrange circular rings one over the other. To get the solid cylinder, I have to arrange these circular plates or disc one over the other without any gap, this one. Now, what is the axis? Axis is nothing but the axis of rotation here. So this is axis. So here I have to draw like this, and it is not visible, don't draw it. This is not invisible, that you can denote with a dotted line, because that is passing through that solid body. Now, what is the moment of inertia? I think you got the answer. For a circular disc, an axis passing through the center of mass and perpendicular to the plane is mR square by 2. But here, for each and every one, this is mR square by 2. For this is first one, I1. And for second one, I2 is equal to mR square by 2. For last one, mR square by 2. If you take R square by 2 common, m plus m, total will become total mass of this one, m, and the radius of this one is r. This will become mR square by 2. That means, if you remember that two formulas, moment of inertia for a disc and moment of inertia for a ring, you can write these values very easily for hollow cylinder as well as for solid cylinder. Now, number 7, the moment that body is a thin rod of length L. Here thin rod means I have to take a rod like this. Here I should not denote the radius of this one. I am not going to take a cylinder. Cylinder is just like a thick rod. But this is a thin rod, means radius is negligible. Thin rod of length L and a negligible radius. So here I am going to take one axis. The axis is perpendicular to the rod. and passing through center of mass of the rod. Here, this is the center of mass of this rod. It is perpendicular to the rod. So this axis is like this, and passing through the center of mass. This is center of mass. This is the axis. Let us say this rod is rotating about this axis like this. Then what is the moment of inertia? The moment of inertia of this rod is given by this is a mass of this rod. Entire rod. Let me take it as m. And the length of this rod is L. Here it is given. Thin rod of length L. Negligible radius, but not the negligible mass. This rod has some mass, but radius is very small. So thin rod. So this is given by m L square by 12. How we got this formula? We are going to learn only in the second PUC, NEET or JEE classes, but not now. Next one. Eighth one. Now I am going to write sphere. We have two types of sphere, hollow sphere and solid sphere. So now let me write first solid sphere. Best example for solid sphere is a cricket ball. Hollow sphere, best example is this plastic ball. Now in solid sphere, about any diameter, so I am taking an axis which is passing through about any diameter. So now let me remove this L here. Now the diagram is, this is a solid sphere. So this is a sphere here. But how to differentiate ring, disc and sphere? For ring and disc, for ring I just denoted like this, ring. For disc I denoted with some lines here, small lines here. But for a disc here, what I am going to write, I am going to fill the entire space here without any gap. So this is how I am going to show the solid sphere here. So this is a solid sphere. Now here I am going to draw an axis which is passing through any diameter. You can take any diameter, you can draw infinite diameters through this one. But here I am going to draw a diameter like this. Remember students, this is not visible. So that's why you can show only half of it. So a dotted line here. Like this. Let the mass of this one is m and the radius of this one is r. So what is the moment of inertia of this solid sphere here? The moment of inertia of the solid sphere about any diameter is given by I is equal to 2/5 m into r square. So this is the moment of inertia of the solid sphere. Now the ninth one is moment of inertia of a hollow sphere about any diameter. Now how to draw this hollow sphere here? I need to draw one hollow sphere. So I am going to draw like this one hollow sphere, just like a circle only. But to show the variation, so this is only the upper surface. So I am going to like this. So this is a hollow sphere. Here how the axis is passing, this is also passing through the diameter only. So this is the hollow sphere and this line is not visible, and you have to draw like this. This is the solid sphere, this is the hollow sphere. Here radius is r, total mass is m, and it is found that the moment of inertia of a hollow sphere is 2/3 mr square. Remember, you have to remember all these formulas. I have this formulas, no problem. Make a chart of it. Prepare a chart and paste in our room so that you can watch all these 9 formulas daily at least for 1 week till we complete this lesson. So without remembering these, we need to solve some problems. There they will not give this moment of inertia, they will just give the mass of this solid cylinder and the radius of the solid cylinder, and they may ask you to find out the moment of inertia of this one. So you have to remember this formula, m r square by 2. Similarly, thin rod, m l square by 12. For solid sphere, 2 by 4 m r square. For hollow sphere, 2 by 3 m r square. Like that, you have to remember all these formulas. Please write all these formulas on a chart or in a big white paper and paste it in front of your bed so that you can see these formulas for another 1 week. Here, after learning all these 9 different formulas, now if you can find the important of moment of inertia of a body in rotational motion. If you take any engines, especially the steam engines or automobile engines, every engine is fitted with, let us say this is the engine, this is fitted with a flywheel, this is a disc which we call it as flywheel. So this is called flywheel. So the engine gives the power to the flywheel, and flywheel will give the power to the rear wheels of an automobile. So the size of this flywheel is too big. So generally it is made big. Why? Because just now we have seen some formulas. This is the flywheel here, and here the mass is distributed on the edge, that is circumference of the flywheel here. So more mass will be distributed on the circumference of the flywheel, and only this will provide like this. This will be designed like this in general. So you might have seen this in so many engines. So here mass will be less, but on the edges mass will be more. Why? Because the moment of inertia of this flywheel or disc, this is actually nothing but a disc here. The disc is going by m r square by 2, where the r is the radius. Here there is no masses. In this area there are no masses. Even though some masses are there, but more mass is distributed on the edges of this flywheel or circumference of the flywheel. So mass distribution is more. On the circumference of flywheel, so while using this formula, the mass, we have to consider the total mass of this flywheel. But what is r here? This mass is a distance of this. This mass is at more distance. But here, r at a small radii, there are no mass. So moment of inertia will be more as more mass is distributed on the circumference. Now, suppose in the same flywheel, this is a flywheel, and more mass is concentrated at the center. So in such case, let us say these are the small attachments given here. As more mass is concentrated at the center, now mass is more and radius is less. M into small r square by 2, then momentum should be less. That means all these flywheels are provided, that means made such that more mass is distributed at the edges or the circumference of the wheel, so that it can create or it will have more moment of inertia. Due to more moment of inertia, what happens? As the moment of inertia is more, that means these flywheels will not allow a sudden change in the speed of the vehicle, either sudden increase in speed or sudden decrease in speed. So due to this moment of inertia, these flywheels prevents jerky motions. That means it will prevent the jerks of a vehicle because of this more moment of inertia. So this, due to this, what happens? It endures very smooth ride. That you can see while traveling in a vehicle. The main difference between a small car and a big car is, in big car these jerks will be less. Why the jerks are less? Why? Because in big cars the size of the flywheel will be big. That you can see in case of Airavat bus, Rajahamsa bus, as well as in Karnataka Sarige bus. Now what is the difference between these three buses? Not only the fare, not only the comfortness, the main thing is, according to our physics, that is the size of the flywheel and the moment of inertia of the flywheel. When the moment of inertia of the flywheel is more, what happens? it will not allow, sudden rise in speed of the vehicle or sudden drop in speed of the vehicle. So that means why these Airavat buses are more comfortable than the other buses? The reason being the size of the flywheel is more. So what is the use of the bigger flywheel? So due to the large size, large amount of inertia, it will not allow or it will resist the sudden rise or sudden drop in the speed of these vehicles.